What's up, everybody? This is day 204, Making Song Bringer. Today I'm working on waterfalls. And yesterday I started this process working on waterfalls. Today I've got it to the point where I'm starting to be a lot happier with how it's looking. So I'm actually quite stoked, actually, how it's going. So the next thing I want to do to this, so yesterday I started this all off with you know, just getting the whole area to kind of look in general like this. And then I finished the day off by kind of getting the waterfall to look somewhat decent like this. So I'm happy with this, how this is started. The next thing I want to do is make it so the back part of the waterfall, right now you can see that the waterfall has this graphic, right? And you can see some sort of streaks in it, but it's static. It's not moving. I want to see that background of that waterfall moving, just constantly flowing down, so I can create a single texture. What's up, you guys? Alex, Arcane, and Momir. What up, guys? So yeah, here's the texture I'm working with. And if you can kind of, I can zoom in, you can see there's some streaks in there. So I basically just want these streaks to move continually. Up, or just go down, 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 down. And I'm going to accomplish that with two sprites. Yeah, it's looking a lot better, huh? A few more touches and I think this will get to be really, really good. And also I need to work on the behavior too. So if I show you what's going on. Hakuna Matata, yeah! So I turn on debug mode, you can see that it's not perfect, right? If I go and walk over there, I'm gonna be able to walk on part of it and stuff. So I gotta dial in these edges too. But that's secondary. First I wanna work on the visual style and complete it and make it look just even that much better. Oh. Actually, we don't even need that. Boom. See if that fixed that little bug that just happened just there. I was refactoring some code the other day. Changed some of that. Cool. We got a clean exit. All right. So I'm going to turn debug mode off and turn on this thing. I started working on this already. This is a slide action. So Marza Power, what up? Yo, man. We got Alex Pita and Marza Power on the stream right now. Two of the four horsemen. That's half the horsemen. Yeah, yeah, always nicer, nicer, nicer. So here's the here's the waterfall as it is, and next I'm working on making it so the background part of the waterfall looks like it's sliding down continually. And I'm just going to do that with one single texture. So basically the goal is to improve this visually and then fix it up behaviorally too. Nice. Cool, cool. I'll have to check out his tweets and stuff later. Next step is Big Mac. Oh yeah, it's changed a lot. It's changed a lot. You'll get to play it soon. The new alpha version, which was originally called the beta, the first beta version, but now it's not quite ready to be called the beta. But I'm still releasing a new version later this month. So you get to play it. Your Steam code you already have will work, and you'll just be able to get the new version. So when you just log into your Steam, it will automatically update it. So, Yeah, that's coming out later this month. So let me show you what I've got so far with this slide action. I've started the slide action out. It's an action based on action interval. And the goal is to create two sprites and use one of them to slide downwards and the other one to, the one of them slides down, the other one slides down too. And then they swap and slide down and swap and slide down. And they use texture recs to make sure that they're not going outside of the bounds of their original size. Yeah, well, I didn't even need to. Nobody submitted any bug reports, so it's cool. Oh, it was really buggy on Windows? What bugs were there? So let's see how this goes with this. I think what's going to need to first change is I need to incorporate the position of the sprite as well as setting its texture rect. Yeah, so there, the slide action is actually getting the rectangle for only one of the sprites at first. And it's working as far as squishing the texture rect down, but it's not offsetting the position as well. So we need to offset the position. Key recognition and mapping? Really? Yeah. I was saying just email me. Really? Well, what keys were you mapping? Impossible to get the sword. Wow, this is the first I've heard of all this. That's weird because it works for me on Windows. I wonder what's going on. What's up, Clock? Sometimes it's sort of. Oh, okay. Alex Peter, I think I know what's going on there with that one. I think it needed to. So let me write down your idea or this bug. Chip took it. There's some default keys I have set up in the game, so maybe it has something to do with defaults. Huh. Yeah. See, all I'm wondering is if this is any different as far as how see Kogo3DX maps thing the keys to like integers. There's all these enums for here they are. Key codes. So these key codes get mapped, right? I have no control over actually how these get mapped. So I'm wondering if these actually map differently on with an Italian keyboard. I doubt they would though, because it's an international engine. Yeah, totally. The standard letters, yeah, I can't see how those would map any differently either. Huh. Yeah, so you just got a few different characters over here, but I can't see how all these would map any differently. Not necessarily. The way I'm not sure exactly how Kogo3DX reads its keys, but it depends on how it does that. I bet you this is not the problem though. It's not this. It's probably something to do with my game. Oh yeah. Well, Arcane, the good thing about this game is it binds to whatever you want. So you rebind all your keys to whatever the heck you want. And this is somehow a problem here for Mars. I'm wondering what the heck is going on here. Yeah, totally. So the way it works is you bind whatever keys you want, right? And then it gets set in your save game. Oh wait, maybe not. Oh, I haven't set this in the save game yet. Okay. Well, I'm gonna make it a very special point to make sure this works in the next version for Mars of Power. So, 'cause this is a big issue. Maybe double binding? I'm not sure what the heck is going on with you, but we'll figure it out. Yeah, Nano. Sorry, man. Here is. Let me turn off this thing here, this action. But here's what the waterfall looks like we'll be working on today. Yeah, there you go. Nice one. Yeah, cool. I'm gonna so Mars of Power, I'm gonna work on that, right? I'm gonna just inspect all the code, try and figure out what the heck was going on there. And then maybe I'll send you a special build. Before I release the actual next alpha version, I'll send you a special build just to make sure it's working. We'll try and figure it out. And cool, nice man, sweet. Yeah, so I'll send you a special build and you can check it out. And what you'll have in your saves game in your saves file, you'll be able to see what binds it's actually using. So that should help us to be like, oh, cool. So it's binding those keys. For some reason, it's not saving my bindings here, but I'll get that working too. So everything is saved in this one save file, and you'll be able to inspect that and see what's going on. Thanks, man. Yeah. Okay, so all right, so let's get back to working on this waterfall. So I want to make this action work, this slide action. So the first thing this slide action needs is to offset its position as well as its texture rec. So sprite set position. Oh, we're probably gonna need an original position actually. Original. Set, this is just set. Let's start with set position Y. Ah, we'll just do the whole thing here. Yes, totally. You throw our flippers in? I don't know. It's so weird that you say that because I had this dream where the character jumped in the water and there was like an underwater level. I just know how much work that's gonna be. But that might be a possibility. But definitely there's going to be secrets behind some of the waterfalls. Not all of them, but some of them will. All right, so we need an original position. So oh, and that might need to get passed in every single time. Yeah, we need to pass this in every time. So, okay, original pause. Original pause, start compiling. Hey, what's up, Mike? If I do end up writing an underwater level, mimicking the original Super Mario music would be great. Da-na-na-na. Oh yeah, could be. Could be. The interesting part of it all, though, is that his I'm using exactly the same code for the menu as well as the game. So it gets all its input and puts it into just this, right? There's only six buttons or eight buttons that can be pressed. So it's using this for the menu and it's using this for the game. So I don't know, I'm not sure what would be going on that would cause that to do. Oh, maybe. Oh, I got an idea. I gotta save this idea before I forget it. Maybe the, what's it called? That might be it. This might be the problem. There might be two event handlers for some reason. Because I'm creating an event handler for the menu, and then I'm creating another event handler. And it's supposed to be releasing the old event handler. So that could be an issue. That would be a definitely a big problem. So, funny, nice. That would be so horrible. But there's got to be one troll world, right? Seahorse mount. Wait, they stopped working in a specific game section? Oh yeah, this is you without the sword. So crazy. It's not in your inventory either. Hey, thanks, Kroz. Cheers, man. Yeah, I think it might be two event handlers. We'll see. I'll definitely work with you to get that fixed for sure. And same thing with Alex Pita. That's it. That's all it is. Okay, so this needs an original position variable because I'm calling it within a repeat action. So that's why it needs that. Wait. Okay. Huh. Well, I'm gonna have to make sure that works too, for sure. I got both these things written down, so. Okay. So yeah, those will be two of my top bugs I've got to fix for this next version, because these are like game breakers right here, for sure. There. Okay, we got it. We got it. Yeah, there's no sword. There's no spoon. There's no sword. Yeah. Dude, I knew it wasn't my fault. It's the Italian customs. It's totally not. It has nothing to do with my code. Oh, it's glad we confirmed that. So we need to move this thing down as I think it's just original size dot height minus S dot height. Let's try that out. There you go. What? Oh, we need a position called. That's right. Dude, I know it, man. You're the pro artist. You're getting commissions all over the place. People want Alex Pita. Alex Pita, Alex Pita, Alex Pita. Open up your doors, let us in. Open, open, open. Man, is this compiling slow or what? Oh, damn it. It's still doing it. Okay, so the good news is... it's still squishing. It just needs to stay at the bottom. A pixel left from the right top pillar? Oh, on this image right here? Oh, this, Momir, this is actually a bat or a butterfly or whatever. It's probably a butterfly flying. He's flying around, right? And he goes, he's got his wings going in and out. And that's what that is. Oh, right, right, right. I know we're trying to keep this secret, but gotta finish this. So the whole goal of this, if anybody's just joining the stream, I'm trying to create this. I'm taking this texture right here, this waterfall texture, and I'm sliding one version of it down, and then another one down right above it, and they swap and go like this and keep going like this forever and ever and ever and ever and ever. So that makes it look like it's actually flowing water. That's my goal for this. And so I'm creating an action, a Cocos 2DX action, which repeats forever and just does that. So this slide action, I'm just trying to get this to work now. So it will, it needs to set its position for sure. Does this need to be multiplied by 2 maybe? No, it needs to be negative, I think. Let's try that. Original pause plus that. No. Three times negative 2. Yeah, I'm writing a slide action. I'm creating this right now. So I copied an existing action. I'm creating this action called slide. And it's just what I said. It's going to take the texture and modify the texture's texture rect so that it looks like it's sliding down. And then it's going to take two copies of the same sprite and keep going like this to make it look like the texture is moving forever. So this should work, right? It should be, all I'm doing is setting the position. It's supposed to be lower than what it is. It's not working at all. Wait, 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 wait. Hey, what's up, Wistoso? Welcome, man. Maybe this is supposed to be r dot size. One of these is gonna work. Hey, what's up, Chaos Gaming? How you been? I haven't seen you guys on in a minute. Hope you're doing good. Damn. Okay, what the hell's going on? Nice, right on. Cool. Yeah, I love it too. I watched this one artist called Anton Kudin sometimes, And he helps me get back in better art zone. He's so good. Okay, I'm kind of baffled. I'm really baffled as to what's going on here. So I'm gonna just start creating some debug output. So this is the time and offset. A bird in the background or in the game? There's definitely birds out here. We live amongst this little copse of trees and there's birds like crazy. What are the starting and ending points of the action? They're just 0 and 1. Nice. Thanks, Chaos Gaming. Okay, so there we saw loop once. Let's see what's going on with this, these numbers. I don't know. Yeah, that hill guy. I'm not sure. Oh, I just realized what's going on. It has nothing to do with this action. Has to do with the fact that this is an entity which has a position component. So we don't need this position component if we want to use this kind of action. Unless I do an empty component and then I do two sprites as children, which might be the thing to do actually. Because that'll give it automatic Z ordering. Actually, yeah, let's try it that way. Okay, well, good to know it wasn't my fault. Yeah, it's setting the position of the sprite outside this loop. Loot 'em dare? No, sorry, I don't have time for doing loot 'em dares. Right? Okay, so I'm gonna create an empty sprite this time. And then add to children. So sprite one, sprite two. Pause totally zero. Anchor 0.5, 0.0. Parent, this is where we get the render.sprite. And Z, doesn't matter, just one's fine. There, now we're gonna run the action on sprite one. First of all, we need to make sure that it's still blending the texture right. And then secondly, we'll see if this actually works with the offset now. Right? Yes, it is. It is. Oh. Ah. What happened? Oh, there, it's doing something over there on the right. It's not colored correctly because we forgot to color it. But it's, why is it way over there? Oh, because we don't need to use pause anymore. The position of it is vec to 0. Whoa. And the color is call. We don't need to do a color here neither. See if that works now. Wow, that's really awesome. Yeah. Four horsemen. Okay, so now it's right. I'm doing too much. I think I'm supposed to be half the position now. That it's, but you can see it's starting to drop. It's starting to look better. So I don't need to log it out anymore. But the offset, I believe, should be 0.5. There you go. Yeah. Or you could just take some any art and make it into ASCII with the ASCII art generator. Oh man, is this supposed to be a quarter? I don't know. I don't know if I want to do that. Because I like this simple. Right? It's gonna look worse for a minute as I get this all working. What the hell is the difference between the original size and the size? It's so weird. Interesting idea. Is this? Let's just let it not do that. I'm really curious what the size attribute of the set texture rect does. See, that didn't do anything. Didn't seem to do anything different. In fact, I think there's even a set texture rect method that doesn't even take a size, if I'm correct. Yeah, so you can just set the texture rect. So let's just try that. Now, Chaos Gaming, there are you can totally mod this game. It's gonna be very moddable. Crazy. Crazy, crazy. Crazy idea. Yeah, you can. You can, Chaos. It's very hackable. The game is storing all of its data right out in the open. So you can go change stuff like colors and placement of foes and everything. The profile, the hit points for a blob, everything you want to change is all in these text files. So it's all very hackable, very moddable. What's up, Vague Lines? Do you mean for Cocos 2DX? I don't know. I don't know. That's typically there really hasn't been great documentation written for Cocos 2DX. Okay, so now that we've got that, let's see what happens if we just do set text direct and use the offset with the negative half. Wait a minute, is it supposed to be times a half? Fumbling today. How is that any different than this? Yeah, Momir, there's going to be a river coming out of it. So that's last on today's list is to make it so. Oh, what? I don't even need to call set position the whole time. Okay, well, there. Okay, I have no idea why that worked now, but it does. A schizophrenic cat, I get you. I totally get that. Yeah, the forum's kind of a good way to learn things, though. Thanks, Clock. Yes, yeah, you can, man. Cocos 2DX works with Visual Studio. There's lots of game engines that use Visual Studio. Okay, so now we need two sprites. We need two sprites in this thing, so. Sprite frame name. I think I can just pass in a sprite ref for this duplicate and keep that as a sprite pointer. Pass this in as well. So this second sprite will be on top of the other one, and it will use a very tiny texture rect at first, and then it'll just go like this, like this, like this, like this. Now it'll create a constant flow of water. Ah. Nice. What's up, Master of Swag? Welcome to the stream, man. Okay, so now that I'm passing in another sprite, let's get the rest of this code written up. Whoops. Thank you. Skin giveaway. What you talking about? Okay, so now I need to create a second sprite that's going to mirror this other one. Sprite 1, sprite 2, same exact thing. Both children of the same parent. And then passing that in. Oh, sorry. Oh, I hate earworm. Oh my God. Earworm. Oh, song stuck in my head forever. So to make it the exact opposite, all I gotta do is use T instead of 1 over T, I think. And then I'll set the duplicates texture rec like that. Duplicate. Cross your fingers. I hope this works on the first try. Later, Chaos. Okay, so it's like, you can see it's partially working, right? Because it's doing, let's give them both different positions. So we'll just offset the duplicate to the right. Or I guess we could make the duplicate gray, and that would kind of show. Well, let's just do this way. But what's going on is it needs to do. This will show. What's up, XPixel? To world's one true time zone. So there, that's revealing what's going on, right? So that's not exactly what I want. I need the the height's correct, I think. Now it's hypnotic. All right, next, let's see. It at least needs to offset its position. Like this old offset thing here. I believe. Maybe not. Maybe the r.origin needs some work. Let's try that. r.origin.y equals this. Or plus equals that. I guess we'll make this an int. See if that works. Yay! Oh man, you got more homework than any of us. Man, this is one of those days where my brain is just not in the whole math zone. But I can work through this. I can do it. I know I can do it. I think I might need to actually set the position of this sprite as well. Let's do just a Vec2 offset before all. Yeah. I know. Maybe I should make art. Oh man. So yeah, if you're new here and you're wondering what the hell's going on, I'm trying to work on this waterfall effect. What I'm doing here is I'm using a single texture, and I'm gonna make this texture look like it's sliding down by using two textures. There's one texture up here and one texture there, and they slide. One moves like this, one moves like this, one moves like that. So I'm just trying to get all the math situated because it's a complex thing because I'm using sprite sheets. Sprite sheets complicate everything because look at this sprite sheet. I'm using this sprite sheet. Here's my little waterfall, right? All the way in the middle of this sprite sheet. So what I'm doing when I'm modifying this texture rect is I'm modifying just this guy's little rect right here. So this is maybe like 600 by 400 just to get to the top of this waterfall. And then it's also flipped on the Y, so everything about modifying texture rects if in the middle of a sprite sheet is very complicated stuff. So that's why this is such a challenge. But I think I'm onto it here. If I get this, if I add this set position Y to offset, I'll just add offset, original pause plus offset. And we can just work in this negative 20 there. See what that does. genetic species, yeah, I have considered palette cycling, but that's a complex technique with and I don't want it to look like, so Lighter Thief gave some great suggestions yesterday. Like, check out these awesome, these are great, great waterfalls, right? That's a beautiful waterfall. That's a beautiful waterfall. All these are great waterfalls, but I don't want to use this kind of technique. This is a different game. I want my own aesthetic. And the aesthetic I'm trying to go for here is a very simple look with some very simple sprites and simple techniques. So the simple technique I'm trying to do is just a simple slide moving this. So palette swapping is not really what I want aesthetically, but it is a cool idea. And in fact, that's what old school games or these kind of games would do, right? I wish palette swapping was easier to do with today's technology. Back in the day, palette swapping was a standby technique, which was so easy to do because you were actually using palettes. Today, there's no such thing as palettes anymore. So it's actually harder than it looks to do palette swapping because you got to write a shader that does that and stuff. Huh? Fist of Awesome. Oh, wow. That's so great. I know, isn't it weird? Oh, it's true. Okay, so it looked like that was offsetting things. Maybe it's not supposed to be times a half. Yeah, that might be it actually, if I take away this times a half. This game? Yeah. Fist of Awesome. Yeah, there we go. That's what I'm talking about. That's what I wanted right there. All right, so it looks like they're one pixel off for some reason. Oh, it could be because that's the integer. So maybe if I take away this integer and this integer, it'll look right. Yeah. Ever wanted to punch a bear in the mouth? Oh my God, I gotta check this game out later. Is that right? Oh, see, it is closer. Okay, so we need like floor F probably or something. Look at this. Oh yeah. The greatest time traveling lumberjack em up of all time. Oh dude. How come I've never heard of this game? Yeah, Jacko Gamer, right? I'm close now. All right, so I think it's floor F. Oh, wait, I was using an int there. That might be it right there, here. Try that. Oh, dude, I'm definitely checking this out. Yeah, oh, it's perfectly lined up now. Awesome. Oh my God, that game looks so awesome. I'm just gonna keep it this way for now. Okay, so let's put this all together. We got zero for its offset, and when we're creating it, we want to use the color here. And then we'll play with the timing to get this visually looking like right. Yeah, it's a good idea, Mars of Power, to use separate actions. That would definitely simplify this technique, right? Oh, okay, the last thing we need to do is make the waterfall's shadow a separate sprite. Okay, so let's start with that. But yeah, Mars Power, I totally agree. That would simplify these actions. But for now, I got this working, so I'm not gonna mess with it too much. But what I typically do is I write stuff all janky and you know, just get it working during the day. And then at night, when I go and check stuff in, I go and improve things and make it better and better. So that's a good thought. So yeah, I'm gonna take this background. What the hell? Oh. Yeah, here's the waterfall's background. Save this for web separately. And then I could turn it off, turn back on this layer, and save this as just the waterfall. I might want to take off these pixels here on the left. Get rid of that little thing. Oh, changing the aspect. Interesting. Thank you, Space My Name. I appreciate you saying that. That's awesome. Cheers. I get this. It's crazy because people say these kind of comments, and it's so surprising to me because I've always been a programmer, and so it's like really cool to be making art that people dig. Yeah. I get you. Okay, so the background is the waterfall. BG. Good one. All right, so now we need an offset since these are this sprite is now bigger. We need an offset right here. Auto. Now we vec2 offset. X is going to be half the width of render.sprite.getContentSize.width. And then use this for these positions, both these. Thanks, man. Thanks for that too. Yeah, well, if you want some advice, I did write a little video series about this. So this is my advice on how to go from being a programmer to being an artist. So maybe this helps somebody out there. A rock poking out would be sweet. Yay, Postman. Yeah, rock poking out would be so awesome. Okay, so now it's not using this. Oh, because this needs to be offset too. The original pause. Right? Yeah, thanks, man. Yeah. No, actually, I actually am Robert Downey Jr. I know, it's Yep, I've been a programmer for a while. Most people don't know that. I make video games. Yay, this is all I wanted. Just the background to do that. Okay, and now I do definitely want to take off that little weird edge. Do a layer via cut for that so I can save it in case I ever want to put it back. I'm gonna take it off for now. Save this for web. Yeah, I know. Without the money. Yes! Oh, this is sweet. Okay, so visually that's looking better than it did before. So you guys that are just joining the stream, I've been on a journey here for like an hour trying to get this whole action to work. So it looks like the background of this waterfall is sliding down continually, just over and over and over and over and over, right? Oh, you know what? I just realized how we could do a rock poking out. Oh my God, let's totally do a rock poking out. I could put a rock sprite right on top of this. Yeah, let's do it. Okay, cool. Art mode. Rock sprite. Give it some depth. Yay! Thanks, Nosferbot. Oh, you guys like the edge, huh? Let's throw it back in. Let's give it another try. Hey, what's up, Ladder Thief, by the way? Yo! Yo! See what feeling that gives it. I guess that does kind of. It kind of gives it more of a wavy feeling. Maybe there should be an offset. Maybe there should be two of them if we're going to go with this kind of technique. Maybe there should be another one on the other side. So there'll be a duplicate of this. It'll be like over here. So that it kind of gives it sort of like a, like this kind of feeling, like it's like almost like a snake or something. Let's see if that works. Yeah, Jacko Gamer, exactly, yeah. Yes. Oh, you don't like it? Yeah, I didn't like it at first either, but let's see what it looks like with two edges. I don't know if I like it either, but let's try it with some more opacity. Maybe if it's at 50%, both those. It might give it more of the feeling and less like it's a just a messed up texture. You're trying to scroll the code window? Oh, all on here? See, now you can barely see it. It's like a little bit too transparent. But it is kind of giving the feeling. That's the most important part of this, I think, is that feeling. So let's do 70% instead. Then we'll do a rock poking out. I think the rock will definitely help. It's a great idea. What? Oh, I think I might have the textures messed up at this point. So that I think those actions are actually kind of they might be broken or they might be using the wrong origin for one of the sprites, like it's squishing down one of them, but then squishing the other one the other way or something, because it's not, that's not perfect. It's not scrolling those right. So I think for now, I think I'm going to come back to this later on and try and fix this all, but for now, I think I'm going to have to comment those out in essence and just like use the pure sprite without those edges. Wait. Hold on. At 100%, didn't these look like they were working? Why did it start failing at 70%? That's curious. Oh yeah, it's totally working. Oh, that's so weird. I wonder why the hell it's doing that at 70%. Oh my God. So there you go. Yes. Yeah, you can wear an eye watch and it gives you special powers in the game. So what if we just go 90%? Oh, wait a minute. This brightness contrast is supposed to be down here. I want my heart rate monitor now. Will the game run on Apple Watch? I don't think so. I don't know. I don't know anything about Apple Watches. It's kind of a cool feeling, right? Okay, let's go to 80%. We'll try and narrow in what the hell's going on with that 70% thing. That'd be cool. But can you even play games on Apple Watches? How do those work? Huh. It almost needs more blending. All right, so this is the last time I'm gonna try one of these because I can't spend two forever just trying this over and over and over. Oh oh no. That means I have to buy an Apple Watch. I don't even want an Apple Watch. There, see? It's doing it again. That's so curious. This whole 70% opacity gets crazy weird. I don't know, I almost like it now. It's so weird. I kind of like it. Oh, is it Half-Life on the Apple Watch? Huh, that could be, yeah. It's making me really curious. Oh, Half-Life, the game. Wow. Dude, that's crazy. Is the game really cross-platform? What you mean? Oh, is Half-Life, you mean? Yes, of course. Of course it will. Clock, man. Dude, you're always cracking me up. Oh, dude. You guys got crazy good jokes today. Oh, man. Okay, I'm gonna do a separate rock layer right on the top of this. Let me get the overworld. sprites. Right. Oh man. Yeah, it is. It's crazy cool. Right, so let's draw a rock. It's time to draw this rock. HyperText Coffee Pot Control Protocol. Oh, dude. Oh, who shared Watt with me the other day? Watt is so funny. There's this video called Watt. It talks about JavaScript. There's coffee all over the world. Dude, I'm checking this out later on tonight. It's gonna give me a laugh, I'm sure. Right? Yeah, it's not going to move with the texture unless I add something on top of it here. So, but well, I want, if I were to draw this rock and put it here, I would want to see the water kind of like curving underneath it. So I want to do like a dark blue color, like basically the same color as the water, but darker underneath it. Or do an animation on top of it. The Rock says, "Know your role, jabroni." Let's try starting by faking it. Just use that. Whoa, what happened? Is it still is it still doing it? Huh, damn, sorry guys. Come on, do it. Wait, 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 wait. Wait, 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 wait. Oh, you totally got me. I totally expected this to actually finish. Oh, good one, good one. You totally fooled me. Oh, man. So, right, it would create some kind of like curtain or waterfall effect like this. All right, so I'm gonna start with this. So just gonna start with some like random rock here. We can see if this is even gonna be a cool technique or not. So if I were to do this right, I would animate it by doing a separate animation for the water right here. So I would get some water to splash off the top of this rock, and this water right here, this curtain of water to kind of go in and out a little bit. So that's how I would do separate animations for the water near the rock and the rock. So then I could apply the color to the rock procedurally here in the code. So that's what I would do. So we'll do a rock sprite now. So let's see that what that looks like with just, I guess that should be two. Oh, dude, that does kind of look cool. Even without an animation, even without coloring. Huh, didn't work for me. Oh, that's what that knocking was. So I'm gonna try this water a little darker and the rock a little darker too. Oh yeah. Yeah, I know. Yeah, I want to see if this even is worth doing, right? First. Yeah, I think this could have merit for sure. This would look really good with some water splashing on the top and the the bottom of it kind of going like that a little bit. I still think it might need to be a little bit more dark. Let's try it. Let's finish this white right now. Might as well do this. So, all right, we'll get this all set up. We'll do this animation proper. Height, we'll give it maybe 32, width 16. That'll allow us some room to splash, to splish splash around. What's up, Jonah19? Dude, you've been missing a crazy party today. We've been trolling each other. Oh, it's been great. Yeah, totally. So yeah, I'll try one at first, but yeah. Oh, that's a great idea. Maui Clay. Maui? I'm just gonna call you Maui. What's up, Live Studios? Interesting idea about low tide, high tide. Okay, starting off, I want a brown. Well, let me just show the original layer back here. We'll get like a gray color in the background so we know approximately what we're dealing with. Actually, I can open up this image. And give it that color. There. So we've got that to start with. We don't need all this craziness. It's good to simplify the layers when you're doing animations because this stuff can get, pretty hairy when you're doing lots of frames. I'm working on the waterfall, so let me show you what it looks like so far. It visually, it looks like this, and now I'm adding this little rock here in the middle of the waterfall. Right, so it's got a rock there, and I want to animate the water coming off of the splashing on top of the rock, and I want to change the rock to be the same color as the rocks around it, and I want to change the yeah. There's gonna be a secret behind here for sure, but I'm not gonna tell you what it is. But okay, yeah. Yeah, so I just wanna animate this little rock and give this whole waterfall some more depth. Sharks? Oh, not just sharks, but space sharks? I'm with you on sharks. But I don't know about laser beams. Laser beams on their heads, that's just too, it's too 1990s. We need like some chainsaws on their heads or something. I'll be right back. I gotta get a drink of water. I'm talking. Sharknados. Did anybody actually watch that movie? You knew the game was missing something. You'll die behind the waterfall. Oh, that would be really cool. Getting out of the waterfall all wet. Did anybody actually watch this movie? Oh, no, that would be rad. That's something I can do for sure. Let me add that to the ideas list. Distorted reflection near the waterfall. A hidden boss of my head. Oh. Right? He's like, ah. Oh, no, that would be sweet. All right, Mars Power. Good night, man. Thanks for joining us. All right, cool. I got a half an hour left. It's time to animate this water splishy splashing off the toppy top of this rocky rock. So two parts of this animation. One is this curtain of water here. First of all, let's see if this curtain needs to be taller, maybe. I guess it could be a tiny bit taller. Yes, oh my God. That's so epic. Epic in every way. Oh no. All right, so this bit here needs to actually be gray. So let's take this color and take out all its saturation. Okay, and I'm gonna get a few animations of this thing. Few frames, I mean. Start with this frame where it, I kind of want to see it widening up a little bit. I think I can work with those, just those three frames. And now let's get some frames where the water is splishy splashing off the top. Do some white. that's horrible. Playing guitar. What's up, Zenoskis? I recommend starting with the game engine. Go play with all the game engines you can get your hands on, like Game Maker, Unity, Unreal. Go get all those. Try them all out and settle on one you like and keep doing tutorials with that game engine until you get really familiar with it. That's probably the best way you can start in game development. Don't worry so much about programming languages. Don't worry about so much about art as much as the whole overall process and getting used to game engines. Yeah, I'm standing. Robots don't need to sit. I wish I could say I'm levitating. Yeah. Yeah, it's Kung Fu. It's Kung Fu. Oh, you thought it was Dr. Fu Manchu? No, it's like Wizard Fu, like Kung Fu. But yeah, I guess that really is kind of an ambiguous name, isn't it? Really? Well, it's probably not the kind of engine you're going to settle on if you're a beginner either. It's a little more advanced. Splish splash, I was taking a bath. Boop, 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 boop. I haven't planned on making it any more pixely. I kind of like it that way. I'm trying to blend the two art styles a little bit, but not too much. But like I was talking about on the stream the other day, I'm going to eventually do this thing where it actually renders the entire game at this tiny, tiny, tiny resolution and then scales it up. So any of the effects I'm doing here, which are kind of more 32-bit, will actually turn out to look 8-bit in the end. Yeah, Construct, that's a good one I should mention more often. Okay, timeline, get this animation started. This is where the party really gets started right here. Yeah, that was. Doesn't it start with Splish Splash? I was taking a bath. I don't really know my lyrics. I don't know if I need this one. Well, the splashy part at the top looks horrible, but I think the part below where the stream is sort of parted by the water, I think that might actually work. Yeah, I agree totally. Yeah, that I'm planning on doing. Some ripples in the bottom for sure. Okay, you know what? Even though this is horrible, as well, nah, I kind of want to export this and try it out in the game really fast, but I think I will try one more try at this to make this less horrible. Oh, okay, I get the problem. The problem is that we don't have enough random layers. This layer right here. No, I'm not gonna do a shader. Yeah, I tried doing a shader for the regular ripples in the game. You can see them. You can see a lot of ripples because there's so many little hoppers on the screen. And I tried making a shader, and it started out, difficult. It's a difficult process to write any kind of shader, right? But it turns out that I could do way cooler ripples with pixel art because I got this whole sp bloop bloop, this little like. The water droplet goes in and then comes back out, and all these little ripples right here. So I can do way more accurate animations with pixel art than I can with shaders. So some cases a shader is the right thing to use. Some cases I don't think it really is. So yeah, I don't know. All right, Clock. Good night, man. Cheers, dude. Oh yeah, I wanna export this, even though it doesn't this isn't perfect yet. I wanna export this and put it in the game right now. So I'm going to export an animation of this whole waterfall. The rock splashing. And now I just want to do another export with the rock. Oh, and I want to put this in. Well, we'll put it here in backgrounds for now. No, species are not a particle system. They're actual separate entities. The flying bugs and everything, I implemented an entire AI just for them. So there's a fly AI, there's a hopper AI. And so what's really simple about it though is these AI just have a single pixel as their frame, right? So there's this whole AI running, but all it is a pixel that just runs that AI. So yeah, it's not really a particle system at all. I think this sprite blend function can create an animation. Oh no, it can't. Oh, Can't do that. Okay. So we need a rock sprite and we need. Yeah, we need two separate sprites, one for the rock and one for the water, because they have separate colors that need to be applied procedurally. Thanks, man. Yeah, it's just a very simple thing. You know, once I got the AI running and everything, it's just like, it was a simple thing just to create an AI with a single pixel. So if I were to run it now, I think it would be too low. Let's see what this rock looks like. I think it's going to be now down really far because it doesn't have as much empty space in the ping file or the texture it's rendering. Yeah, okay, so now it's down way down at the bottom. Let's get we'll add some randomness to it a little bit. Like, let's do drand f times 4. And we'll do like 12 plus drand f01 times 4. So I'll kind of like randomly position this. Hey, what's up, Wolfsky? Welcome to the stream, man. I'm working on a waterfall. So I can do, now I can color this rock part. So get color mix, K, color rock. Where is this thing? Oh, it's just XY. All right. See what that looks like so far. Yeah, definitely. I'll add that in later. That's a really simple thing. Just add a little random variable. Let's just do that right now, actually. If drand f01 is less than 0.f. Good call, Arcane, for sure. There should sometimes not be this rock. Let's hope that this actual random number comes out so that we do have the rock this time. Oh, and that shouldn't be a DRAND. That should be an actual RAND based on the tile. Okay, good. So we still got it. That's good to know. So this should be this get RAND. Let's do 3fxy, it's less than 0.5. And it looked like it needed to be a lot higher, so we'll do 16 maybe. What's up, Vanilla? Welcome, man. I'm working on making the art for this waterfall better than yesterday. Okay, so this screen is not gonna have that, so let's just flip that right there. Because based on its random numbers for this particular area, it wouldn't have had the rock. So there, we've got a rock, cool. It looks like it's not high enough though. Let's put it up higher. A little bit more. And we'll start adding in this next thing. We want to do like a splash sprite. So waterfall, rock, splash, zero. Put it on top of that one, and we want to make it the same color as the water, and then animate it. That's a good point, Arcane, right? Yeah, cool. I'm glad you like it too. That was something that I went back and forth on trying to get that to. I didn't like it at first, but yeah, it turned out better than. Better now that it's a little more transparent. So I'll create this animation for that splash. Okay, hopefully that works and it's in the right place and it makes it color too. Good night, Ladder Thief. Cheers, man. Yeah, all right. That's all I wanted to see was that this animation is like actually working now. So the white's a little bit too bright. And the whole white, the whole animation for all the splashing on top of the rock is just not looking that great yet. So, but it's a good step, right? Having this all hooked up in the code is a great thing. So I'm not going to need this whole rock. I can just create that rock there. So I'm going to start with... to make all these white layers. Actually, first of all, off, I hate these little splashes on the left. They're really weak. And I'd like all these to be maybe opacity of like 50%. Oh, and also the background thing, the where the water parts, this thing, we could give it like 80% opacity. So this becomes more like a shadow. And okay, and let's fix the animation so the little splashes on the left and the right don't look as horrible. Let's get rid of them. What if these were... ...30%? Yeah, that's looking a lot better. Yeah. Oh wow. So I want to make the edges a little more opaque or more transparent of the splashes, and I want to make the shadow darker. So this is how dark the shadow is right now. It's not very dark at all. Let's take that down to half what it was. Now I'm just like making the little. Yeah, maybe I need to make that a little faster. Falling pixels and all that. I'm actually making these little white pixels just a tiny bit more transparent now. Just touching them up a little bit. I think that'll really help this whole image. What's up, Arctic Raj? I'm using the Xcode color scheme that's just exactly like the default, but I made the background dark and I put it on GitHub for people to share with everybody. So here it is. There's a link to it. All right, let's see how this looks with those touch-ups. Whoa, man, that shadow is now a little bit too dark. But the splashy pixels on top are looking better. And let's make this pixels move a little bit faster. Particles. Yeah, you're welcome, Arctic. I think this is their speed, 0.45. Yeah, speed. Let's bump them up to 0.5. And the darkness. How did this darkness get to be so dark? That's suddenly. I think it was at 30 before. Maybe it was 40 before, actually. That shadow's still a bit dark. It's crazy. How does it look if you eat a cactus? Let's try that. That's definitely something you always got to try in every new piece of art, right? Let's find out. Oh, wow. That's so crazy how it adds so much glow to the to that foam. Dude, that was awesome. Hell yeah. Oh no. Oh. What's up, Bruce Bear? What happened? What happened to your eyes? Oh no. I liked it. I liked it myself. Yeah, if I go any lighter on that shadow underneath the rock, it might get a little bit too bright. I think that's about the sweet spot right there. So yeah, man, I think I like this. I like how it's turning out. You think it should be more blocky? I could try some blocks. Yeah, Arcane, someone just a second ago was suggesting that it should be transparent shown through. So I guess it's either way you look at it, huh? Oh, nice, cool, man. I'm glad you had a good trip. So yeah, I think that's about it for today. I've totally run out of steam here. Myself, I gotta take a break, but let's take one last look at this and just kind of appreciate what got done today. So since yesterday, this waterfall has gotten a lot better looking. The next thing I'm gonna start doing is making it so you can actually walk correctly up here. So right now I can collide right here, but I'm not colliding on some of these. Like I shouldn't be able to walk on top of this rock right here. So I gotta fix that, right? And also there's gonna be a river coming out of the bottom of this pool, and it goes down to this screen below it. So when you're on, see how there's a river coming out of it right here on this part of this area? That needs to connect up to this pool. And then there'll be a bridge going over the river. And then you'll also be able to walk behind a few of these random waterfalls. Like some of these waterfalls, you'll be able to actually walk behind, and there might be a secret, maybe there's not. Look how far you can go north, though. It's so wrong. But anyways, yeah, that's what I'm going to be working on tonight. So, great stream, you guys. Thanks for joining me on today's journey. Oh, the lines. Oh. Okay, Arcane, I get you. I see what you mean. Yeah, good night, Nostrobot. Yeah, Brunsbear, sorry about that. I'm trying to do earlier streams for people in Europe. So, yep, I'm trying to start earlier, like 2 p.m., 3 p.m. my time, which is a few hours earlier than I used to be streaming. So, when you come back, you're wearing women's clothes. Yeah, thanks, you guys. Cheers.